Yeah, so as far as what we can expect, we're hoping that the weather stays stable throughout the rest of the day today and early evening hours. But we could potentially expect some heavy rains in the this evening into tomorrow morning. So, of course, the flood watch remains in effect through Saturday at 6 p.m. So we need to continue to maintain our vigilance throughout that time.
Are there shelters set up anywhere?
We haven't opened any shelters preemptively, but we have done some preliminary coordination with our partners to ensure that if the need arises, we can quickly open those shelters.
I know you mentioned storm drains and sending out crews to clear those. What else in the city jurisdiction are you supposed to do in as far as preps?
So main thing for us is communication and ensuring that all the departments have the information that they need to quickly take action as necessary. But of course, we're doing communication checks and ensuring that all of our systems are ready to go.
So some people are saying, it doesn't look too bad. I feel safe. What would you want to see to that?
And of course, right now the weather on Oahu is looking okay, but we have seen some impacts materialize on the Big Island already. And so that possibility is there. So definitely, folks, we encourage folks to continue to pay attention to your surroundings, but also to the local news and information coming out from official social media and other sources like H&L Info.
And if anyone does experience any damage to their homes or maybe, on their roads or anything, is there a way they can report that to the city?
Yeah, of course, for any kind of emergency situation, of course, the first line is 911 and to report those. If we start seeing additional impacts to homes, for instance, we will set up a portal in which folks can report their damages. But for now, if any emergency situations, please call 911.
And so we're concerned about, boulders coming down the mountain. Obviously, we had two incidents where that happened. Is there anything you folks are doing to address that?
So for us specifically, we'll take action where it's our jurisdiction to do so. But in the case of private property to private property, the governor has the jurisdiction and authority according to state law. So we will refer those to the state as necessary. And so for us, we're continuing to maintain open lines of communication with the State Emergency Operations Center.
So what advice are you giving the community right now?
Say again?
What advice are you giving
To
to the public?
To the public. Yeah, for the public, we ask that everybody continue to maintain vigilance. Even though we're not seeing any severe impacts on Oahu just now, we continue to have the potential for that. So please continue to pay attention to local news. And really pay attention to your surroundings. As you're driving out on the roads in the afternoon commute hours, just be a little patient, drive extra carefully and with aloha, and hopefully everybody makes it out of this event safely.
This is going to be mostly a rain event, not a wind event, correct?
Right now, the main focus is on rain, but it's possible that associated with the rain, if we get any kind of a flare-up of the weather system, we could have some localized heavy wind events, but right now the primary focus is on rain.
Is there a way the public can help the city out if they see anything or anything like that?
So of course we have our reporting mechanism through 311, Honolulu 311, but also any kind of emergency situation, of course, 911 is the way to go.